वेलकम टू ऑल माय डियर भैया बहन इन इंग्लिश क्लास टुडे। वी ऑल आर हियर अगेन टू रीड द सेम बुक द सेम चैप्टर ऑन द फेस ऑफ इट। हाउ आर यू माय डियर? वेरी गुड, यू आर समहाउ वेरी वेल। इन द प्रीवियस क्लास वी डिस्कस्ड अ लॉट रिलेटेड टू Dairy speech, Mr. Lamb's speech, what Mr. Lamb told to Dairy, what Dairy told Mr. Lamb. Mr. Lamb tried too much to console Dairy, but as we know that he was young, so that he was unable to understand what Mr. Lamb wanted to say him. Now today you see the speech starts from Dairy. Do you have any friends? And you read this dialogue and I will explain its meaning. This dialogue is up to Dairy. How could I? You pass people in the street and you might even speak to them, but you never see them again. It doesn't mean they are friends. Now see what Mr. Lamb and Dairy speaks in this paragraph, in this dialogue. Dairy asked in this paragraph if Mr. Lamb had any friends, and he replied that he had a few hundred of them. Dairy further said that it still he lived alone in such a big house. Mr. Lamb said that everyone was his friend. Many people visited the garden. The gate remained open. They sat there by the fire in winter season. Kids came to pick apples and pears and to take the honey toffees made by him. Dairy said that he wasn't a friend of Mr. Lamb's. He said that Dairy was a friend because he had not done any such thing that should seize their friends. Dairy said that they did not know each other well to become friends. Mr. Lamb did not consider that to be important. He did not need Dairy's particulars before becoming friends with him. Mr. Lamb said that if he wished, he could tell him his name. Dairy replied that his name was Derek, but he disliked it and wanted to be called Dairy instead. He added that he might not visit the place in future, and then they would not remain friends anymore. Mr. Lamb asked the reason and Dairy replied that one crosses many people while walking down the street, might speak to a few of them and never see them again. This did not mean that they had become friends. So my dear, in this paragraph we have seen Mr. Lamb asked Dairy's name. Dairy told that his name was Derek, and he also told him he disliked his name. He wanted his name to be called Dairy. And he also told there are so many people who come and go on the road, they are not become friends. So this did not mean that they had become friends. Dairy said that if I have come to your garden, you don't think that we are friends. Now see the next dialogue. This dialogue starts from Mr. Lamb. Its line is, doesn't mean they are enemies either, does it? And the dialogue up to and this dialogue ended up to Dairy's speech. It would stop them. They would mind me. When they saw me here, they look at my face and run. again what they are talking in this paragraph. You see, Mr. Lamb commented that it did not mean that strangers were enemies. All strangers are not enemies. If not friends, Derry said that they were nothing, just people. Mr. Lamb said that it could not be that people were nothing to each other. Derry said that there were some people whom he hated. Mr. Lamb replied that hatred would harm him more than the acid that had only affected his face. See the line. Mr. Lamb said, hatred is more ugly things than the acid. So if you are hating anyone, it is not good. It is more dangerous than the acid. Acid can burn you at one place, but hatred can burn your whole body. Mr. Lamb said that a bomb explosion blew up his leg, but there were worse things. But there were worse things that could happen. One could burn himself up from the inside by the negative feelings. Derry said that when he had returned from the hospital, a person had said it was better if he had remained there with people like him. He added that people think all disabled people should remain together at one place. Mr. Lamb added this meant that people without legs should remain together and the world without become imbalanced that way. Derry said that at least no one would stare at the other because all of them were similar. Mr. Lamb asked Derry that did he mean that he was like all other people with burned faces just because they had similar appearance? He added that everything was different. Although all things are the same, yet they are different. Derry was confused. Mr. Lamb said that our habits of watching, listening, and thinking differently made us different from each other. Derry said that he liked Mr. Lamb's house and garden. He replied that Derry was always welcome there. Derry said that the place was not his. Mr. Lamb said that everything was his if he wanted it to be. He added that all his possessions were for everyone. Derry asked if he could visit the place again, and Mr. Lamb replied that he could and he would find company too. He added that Derry needn't mind other people. No one would stop him from entering the premises. Derry said that they probably would not like to enter the place upon seeing him. Maybe they would look at his face, get scared and run away. In this paragraph we have seen Mr. Lamb and Derry talked with each other, and Derry wanted from Mr. Lamb and demanded that he should come again in his garden. Mr. Lamb said why not? His garden is open for all. Derry said that if he will come, other people will not come because other people will be afraid of him and run away from him. So that Derry wants to express his ugliness before Mr. Lamb, and Derry wanted to say how he is scared by the people and people are scared by him. So see the next paragraph again. This speech starts with Mr. Lamb they might not. You would have to take the risk. So would they. From this this line from the speech, Mr. Lame. Ah, if you chose, I don't know everything, boy. I can't tell you what to do. Fuss. Here is a word. Fuss means so of anger or worry. What do they talk themselves in this paragraph? You see, in this paragraph, you will see Mr. Lamb replied that they might or might not run away, and that he had to take a chance on them. Derry said that Mr. Lamb had to choose out of him and other people as visitors because no one liked to remain near him. Mr. Lamb would lose all his friends if he had Derry in his garden. Mr. Lamb said that he was there and did not run away on seeing Derry. He added that when he went out on the street, kids teased him, although they visited his garden and his house. It was like a game. They were not scared of him because he was not scared of them. Derry asked that, did his leg get injured in the war? And Mr. Lamb replied that it did so. Derry asked that, how would he climb up the ladder to pluck the apples? He replied that there were a lot of things that he had learned to do. Derry added that if he climbed the tree alone, fell from it and broke his neck, he would lie on the grass, dead. Mr. Lamb said that it could happen. Derry asked if he could help him pluck the apples. Mr. Lamb said that he could help him if he wanted to. Derry said that his mother would be waiting for him. His home was 5 miles away, across the fields. He was 14 years of age, but still he was supposed to tell her where he was. Mr. Lamb added that people had the habit of worrying. Derry added that actually they were in the habit of fussing. Mr. Lamb asked Derry to go home and inform his mother of his whereabouts. His house was 3 miles away. As the weather was fine and he had legs, he could easily go home, tell them and return. Derry said that once he went home, he would not be allowed to return. Mr. Lamb added that once home, Derry himself would not feel like coming back. Derry said that Mr. Lamb did not know what all he could do. Mr. Lamb said that only Derry knew what he could do. Derry started to say that if he chose, but was interrupted by Mr. Lamb. He said that Derry had to choose and he could not tell him what to do. In this paragraph we have seen, now Derry wanted to go his home. He told Mr. Lamb that his mother would be waiting for him. And he also told that if he will go home, he will come again there. But Mr. Lamb said, people tell like this, but when they go, they don't recall. What happened in next paragraph? You see the dialogue starts from Derry. They tell me. From this dialogue to the dialogue of Mr. Lamb. Okay? See what happens in this paragraph. When Derry said that he wanted to go home, Derry said that his family forced him to do things their way. Mr. Lamb said that it was Derry's wish to agree with them or not. Derry was confused about what he wanted, something that was only his and no one had it like the garden. Mr. Lamb said that he could find out what he wanted. Dairy asked how he could do that. Mr. Lamb told him to wait, watch and listen. He added that he had to see the bees. Dairy asked that, did the other visitors talk to Mr. Lamb? Mr. Lamb replied that some did while some did not. Dairy said that he did not believe that someone ever visited the place. Mr. Lamb lived alone all by himself. No one cared for him. Mr. Lamb said that Dairy could think as he pleased. Dairy asked him the names of some of the visitors. Mr. Lamb said that names were nothing. They could be like Tom, Dick or Harry. He left to see the bees. Dairy said that perhaps Mr. Lamb was mentally challenged. Mr. Lamb said that was good excuse for Dairy. But Dairy said that Mr. Lamb did not talk sense and that's why he said so. Mr. Lamb repeated that it was a good excuse for not returning to the garden. Dairy's face was burned, which was other people's excuse for not seeing Dairy. Dairy said that Mr. Lamb was like other people. If he was not sorry that his face was burned, then maybe he was scared of it. If not that, then maybe he thought that Dairy was as ugly as a devil. He added that he was a devil. Dairy shouted. Mr. Lamb did not reply. He had gone to see the bees. Dairy became calm and said that Mr. Lamb did not think him to be a devil. He liked to be in the garden. Dairy got up and shouted that he was leaving and that he would return to see him. He did not have a tin leg, could run and would be back soon. Dairy ran off. The place was silent with the sounds of the creatures of the garden. Mr. Lamb talked to the bees that they saw all that happened. They all knew that no one ever returned to the garden. In this paragraph we have seen, after talking with Mr. Lamb, Mr. Dairy told Mr. Lamb, who are the people come to this garden? Please name those people. Mr. Lamb said, names are nothing. People will come here. People will talk to me. Children will come here. Children will talk to me. If you will afraid of anyone, people will afraid of you. So my dear, after telling this, Dairy ran off the garden and again the garden became silent with the sounds of creature of the garden. And Mr. Lamb talked to the bees that they saw all that happened. They all knew that no one ever returned to the garden. And again Mr. Lamb became the friends of garden things like all birds, creatures, fruits, etc. Now Dairy went away from Mr. Lamb's house telling that he must return his garden again and he will talk with Mr. Lamb. And what happened in scene 2 we shall read on the next day. And today is your homework. You will prepare question answer from this story, the character of Mr. Lamb, the character of Mr. Dairy, and contrast between the character of Mr. Lamb and Mr. Dairy. In this way, today we are going to finish this class. Next day we shall meet again. Till then, thank you. Have a nice day.